A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 4th June, on the front page you have mandatory Hindi goes out of draft education policy. So new version of the policy has come forth, which removes clause stipulating the languages students must choose. So because of protests coming from southern states, especially Tamil Nadu and even from Kolkata, the mandatory Hindi now is no longer part of the three language policy or the language policy under the draft education policy. Below you have 9 Muslim ministers, 2 governors stepped down in Sri Lanka. So a monk had called for the ouster too. So these ministers, including 4 of cabinet rank, resigned, taking a collective stand against the community being demonized since the Easter Sunday terror attacks in Sri Lanka. Then below you have AN-32 with 13 on board missing over Arunachal. So this is an Indian Air Force AN-32 transport aircraft with 13 people on board. It has gone missing over Arunachal Pradesh. It had taken off from Jorhat in Assam. On page 3 you have CMs move on public transport a different ball game altogether. So experts have raised questions ranging from affordability to sustainability on Delhi government's decision to provide free access of state-run public transportation to women. So this is a detail regarding that. And below you have High Court stays center notification on commercial rights of ships. So petitioners had contended that the notification of the central government was irrational, and now Delhi High Court has stayed this notification. The notification was under Make in India program. So under which it was said that Indian built ships will get commercial rights higher than the Indian flag vessels in securing Indian business. So those are also Indian vessels but are not made in India. The vessel ship has not been made in India. So Indian built ships, even if they are if they are used by foreign entities, they would get higher commercial rights. So that is an irrational notification, and the Delhi High Court has stated. Then on page 7 you have state plans rupees 50 crore CCTNS overhaul. So this is Maharashtra state government which has decided to upgrade the entire crime criminal tracking network system project. So there have been complaints of glitches in the system. So the supplementary demand will be presented in the monsoon session in assembly for this 50 crores of the CCTNS project as such. On page 8 you have Kerala steps up surveillance to tackle fresh Nipah threats. So this Nipah virus had been in news earlier too and is again in news, so you should know about it. So travel history of suspected patients is being checked, and 86 people are under observation in Kerala. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is crisis diffused. So this is regarding compulsory learning of Hindi language. So that part has been dropped from the draft education policy. It's the front page news today. So it's the editorial says that compulsory learning should be limited to the child's mother tongue. And even why would that be too? Then Behemoth's shadow. So this says Bihar's Chief Minister Nitish Kumar is clearly sensing the BJP breathing down his neck. So this is again political. Bihar Chief Minister, that is JDU leader Nitish Kumar, the party is an ally with BJP at the center, and he wanted more seats or seats commensurate with the votes which they have got, but every ally was given only one seat by the BJP government at the center. So Nitish Kumar was unhappy. So this is actually a political editorial. Then this is the lead article, A Rocky Road for Strategic Partners. So this is about Trump administration failing to distinguish friend from foe. So there have been decisions taken by US administration that have adversely affected India too. So this is about India-US relations. And this is the sum and substance of the jobs data. So recently we came across the data saying that unemployment is at 45-year high. So this article says that rising unemployment must also be seen as a function of rising education and aspirations. So it's actually an article showing that how rising education and aspirations result in rising unemployment. But then still we need a solution for that. Then on the op-ed page you have the changing idea of a university. So this article talks of why education system in India is staring at a dismal future, because the new draft education policy which has been proposed and the 100-day action plan for education the government has proposed. So this is a critique on that. Then on page 13 you have forged signatures used in case against Kargil veterans. So this is regarding the case against former Assam border policeman himself, that he is not a citizen of India and an illegal migrant. So three people had filed cases against the Assam border police inquiry officer, and they had used their signatures as witnesses in the case, and now it is seen that the forged signatures were used. This is the NRC case, further details on that. And here you have Ud Chuno to give new lease of life to wounded soldiers. So this is an initiative which will be launched by Army Rehabilitation Center today. Then on international page you have protests, tanks and official silence. So this is regarding the 30th anniversary of Tiananmen Square crackdown in Beijing in China. And here you have North Korea's former nuclear envoy reappears. So there was news that he has been sent to a labor camp, but he has reappeared now. And this is China warns students of risks of studying in USA. So China has warned its students and academics on the risk of studying in the USA, citing an uptick in visa denials and delays amid a trade war and other tensions between China and USA. And this is 13 killed as Sudan military breaks up sit-in. So Sudan's military rulers forcefully broke up a week-long sit-in outside Khartoum's army headquarters, leaving at least 13 dead. So the heavily armed security forces in pickup trucks mounted with machine guns were deployed in large numbers all around the capital now. So number of people have been killed in this too. The number of martyrs, it is said, has risen to 13. So actually they were demanding, you know, reforms as such in the governance, but the protests which were taking place, the ruling military council has broken down those protests and used brute force against it. On business page you have Nilekani panel suggests 24/7 RTGS NEFT elimination of all charges. So this is Nandan Nilekani. A committee had been established under him to encourage digital payments, and he has suggested, the committee has suggested measures like include elimination of charges, you know, which are there for digital payments, round the clock RTGS and NEFT facility, and duty free import of point of sale machines. So point of sale machines which are used for digital payments, they should be imported duty free. So these are some of the suggestions. Then here you have manufacturing sector PMI gains in May. So that is purchasing managers index. So for the month of May, it has made a gain, and it is above 50, so there is an expansion in the economy. So this is a private sector survey. So for manufacturing, we have IIP, Index of Industrial Production, which is a government survey, and PMI in manufacturing is actually a private sector survey. And this is Global Entrepreneurship Summit 2019 to have 27 Indian entrants. So the 9th edition of Global Entrepreneurship Summit is set to roll out in The Hague on 4th June. So Indian entrepreneurs will also be joining in. And on the last page you have mutation that protects against HIV raises death rate. So such studies suggest that tinkering with genes may cause problems. So the Chinese researcher had also, Mr. Hu had also tried to do this. So now this is a study on how a mutation that protects against HIV can raise death rates. And this is scientists edit chicken genes to make them resistant to bird flu. So this is a development which is a key step in preventing spread of the disease to humans. So this is chicken genes being edited. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website ashr.com. Thank you.